Hecky thump. I've just been lekking with our kid, and he had some brass in the pocket of his kegs. He said some lass down the road give it to him to buy some spogs or something. Any road? Fancy a brew? What? Yes, that is English. It's all from Yorkshire, and in this lesson I'm going to explain everything to you so that you can understand people from Yorkshire like me. I'm also going to teach you 10 words that only people from Yorkshire will understand. Are you ready? This channel helps you speak English more clearly and understand native speakers more easily. So if you want to understand people from Yorkshire, you're gonna need this lesson. Now, Yorkshire is one of the most distinct accents of English. It's heavily influenced from Old Norse, which is actually medieval language that they used in Finland, Sweden, Norway. So when we combine that with some very, very distinct pronunciation characteristics, we have one of the most famous and beautiful varieties of British English. Now, as I said, I am from Yorkshire. I was born and spent all my childhood in a small town near Huddersfield in West Yorkshire. Now, Yorkshire is a beautiful part of the country. I was born in Yorkshire. I grew up and spent all my childhood in Yorkshire until I was 18 when I went to university in the south of England. And only then did I realize how strong my Yorkshire accent was. Sometimes I had to repeat myself to people in the south of England because they didn't understand my accent the first time. And secondly, how we had a lot of vocabulary that were normal for me that people in the south didn't understand. Now, one of the most famous characteristics of Yorkshire English is that we don't use the word the. I live in Spain, and in Spain they have four words for the: el, la, los, las. And I think other languages have more than four words. English just has one, Yorkshire has none. So listen to this sentence. I went to the station the other day to buy the ticket for my holiday. In Yorkshire, we don't use the word the, so it sounds like this. I went to station other day to buy ticket for my holiday. We don't completely delete the word the, but we use the glottal stop instead of the word the. So it's not I went to station, but it's I went to station. Isn't becomes in, it isn't becomes in, and it isn't in the tin becomes tin, tin, tin. So yes, we really like to make things short in Yorkshire English. Something, anything, nothing, summit. Oh, no. Thank you is a long word. The rest of England say thanks to make it shorter. But in Yorkshire, we make it even shorter by saying ta. Ta. Eyup means hi. Eyup. Ta-ra means bye. Ta-ra. Aye means yes. Aye. Nay or na means no. Nah. And we have some wonderful expressions to express surprise, like by heck or hecky thump. And if we are surprised at the expensive price of something, we say ah much. Ah, much. Oh, and any road means anyway. Way is a kind of a road, so I guess it makes sense. Any road. Oh, and one really, really confusing thing about talking to people from Yorkshire is that dinner means lunch and tea means dinner. That was very confusing when I was making plans with my southern friends at university to meet for dinner. I was waiting for them at 12 o'clock and they were waiting for me at 6 o'clock. Very confusing. Yorkshire is a beautiful place with great people. In fact, people from Yorkshire love Yorkshire so much that they refer to it as God's own county. Maybe because they haven't traveled to the rest of the country, but still, we love it and we call it God's own county. Now, let's have a look at some words that only people from Yorkshire understand. A bairn means a young child or a baby, a bairn. Instead of money, we say brass. We sometimes say cup of tea or cuppa, but we also use the word brew. You want a brew? Oh, I'd love a brew. A butty is a sandwich. bacon butties are my absolute favourite. We often use the word lass instead of girl. You might know the word kid, which means child, but if someone from Yorkshire says our kid, they are referring to a younger sibling, a younger brother or sister. Our kid. This doesn't have to be when you're a child. I know people my age who refer to their younger brother as our kid. Kegs are trousers. Kegs. And we use the verb to leck instead of to play. This was really, really common when I was a child growing up in England. My friends would call or knock on the door and say, are you lecking? And that simply meant, are you coming out to play? Are you lecking? Then we have some reflexives. Instead of myself, yourself, himself, and herself, we say missen, thisen, hisen, and hersen. So not I'm looking at myself in the mirror, but I'm looking at missen in the mirror. Have you hurt yourself? Have you hurt thisen? And another word I used a lot when I was a bairn, when I was a kid, is spogs and spice. Spogs and spice both mean sweets, candy, sweets that children eat. I always used to ask my dad, hey dad, got any brass for some spogs? Have you got any money for some sweets? Right, I've got two wonderful bonus expressions for you now, which are almost impossible to understand unless you know them. Do you live in a barn? Do you live in a barn? If I say that to you, what I'm actually saying is, please could you shut the door? The next expression is, put wood in oil. Put wood in oil. This is literally put the wood in the hole, which again means please shut the door. So let's have a look at what I said at the very beginning of this video and let's translate it into standard English. Ecky thump. I've just been lecking with our kid and he had some brass in pocket of his kegs. He said some lass down road gave it to him to get some spogs or summer. Penny road. You fancy a brew? So what I meant was this. Wow. I've just been playing with my younger brother and he had some money in his trouser pocket. He said a girl down the road gave it to him to get some sweets or something. Anyway, do you want a cup of tea? If you liked this lesson, definitely watch those two next. And if you subscribe to the channel, I'll see you for the next lesson on Friday. If you don't, I may never see you again. So click subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you then. Bye for now. Or should I say, ta-ra.